What's happening, everyone? May 1st, FOMC Day. Welcome to the FOMC live stream. About 14 minutes until the data is released. 30 minutes later, Jerome will take the stand and say a bunch of repetitive stuff that he always does. But as you all know, if you've looked at my trade plan, two trades I plan to take are here in a few minutes. I will enter an iron condor right before the data release. Hopefully get a little theta decay without too much movement. Book some profits on that. And then after Jerome hits the mic, I will buy some premium to try to benefit from a bigger move. So that is my plan. We got a nice little bonus this morning from the O2 double diagonal. That was nice. Crean came through hot. Crean came in hot with a profit target in about 60 seconds. So I'm going to use Trade Steward to enter. It's going to be a $4.60 wide iron condor. Right now we've got, what do we got? 80s and 75s, 105 wide. Beautiful. I think we were over 100 wide last time as well. And that's usually historically not that wide. So hopefully price can stay within range and get a little decay for us. If I hit 30% before exit time, I'll take half off. Otherwise, I'll just ride it until the exit time. I go $4, Dave S. But yes, you are correct. Oh, for the next one. Yeah, gotcha. That should pinch together unless some big shocker that comes out with the data that wasn't expected. We got the VIX at 15.77, not too far off from where it opened. Had a little pop up, pull down. S&Ps are minus 12. NASDAQ down 106. Russell and the Dow are a little bit green. Gold and silver up a little bit. Notes and bonds green. 10-year yield down about 0.5%. Energy is down. Oil is down 3.5%. Natty gas is down over 2%. Grains are mixed. Euro and the pound flat mix. Bitcoin down 3%. I do not use a trailing stop now. All right, it is go time, so I'm going to go ahead and fire it up. Should come in on the 80 calls and the 75 puts. Filled at 7:15. All right, locked in. Now we wait. 9 minutes from now. Anybody else doing something different? I did put on a 2-5, kind of a TGIF style double calendar earlier. And I'll see what that does. I may take that off today or tomorrow. Lot of times, as long as price stays in the range, you'll get some nice decay in those front options. Just got filled on my iron condor, naughty dog. The long strangle doesn't happen until after Jerome starts speaking here in about 30 minutes or so. Yeah, so if anyone's new to the FOMC stream or just as kind of a refresher, the logic behind what I'm doing here is a lot of times when the data is released here in 7 minutes, you don't typically get a ton of price movement. You will see it start to jump around, but typically it's not too much, but you do get some decent theta decay starting to come in because now the uncertainty is starting to come out, right? They've released the data. So I'm selling premium to try to take advantage of that. And then once the press conference starts, usually during or after the press conference is when you really start to see the move. So after the press conference starts, about 5 minutes after the press conference starts, I buy premium to try to capture some of that movement because we've typically seen some decent decay. So we're buying those options a little bit cheaper and then looking for a big move to profit. I manage the entire thing, but you definitely want to watch your longs. I'm doing it with my bot, so it'll automatically adjust if the longs go bidless. But I did have a situation a few meetings ago where I wasn't paying attention to the longs and I was trying to manage the entire iron condor and I couldn't get out. I was trying to figure out what was going on. It took me a minute. Ended up taking a little bit bigger loss than I should have because of that. Yeah, with 60 wide, I can't imagine the longs are going to go bidless in this case, but calls are 40 cents. Oh, they could. Puts are 40 cents. So, yeah, they definitely could. Your strikes look right to me. Elliot, you just got to squeeze your graph in. Look at my screen. Yeah, just drag the bottom like this. What are you new to toss? That's like a question Krish would ask, Elliot. Come on. All right, 3.5 minutes here. I'm not mean to Krish. That's all out of love, Ken. I only pick on the ones I love. Plus, Krish deserves it. It was okay. PSD financer hit profit target in like 60 seconds. If you scroll up in this channel, you'll see all the ranting and raving about it. It was literally, didn't even know what happened before it hit profit target. I went in and I double dipped. I went in for seconds, took a little bit more. Getting a little premium pumped in. Don't know. I've been trying to figure that out all day, Krish. I think we go down. I think we see some more red. Which I know you agree with, which makes me hesitant. Dick K is going up. Dick K, what are you playing anything? Directional? I don't care what you have to say. I want to know where I want to see where your money's at. Did anyone else put Iron Condors on at the open today? I mentioned in the chat, I forgot to turn off my bot, so all my re-entries fired. And I was like, oh no. And I went in and turned them all off. And then by the time I got around to closing the trades, they were all up between 6 and 8%. So there's a serious little premium crush right out of the gate. Okay, data should be posted. Course rate staying unchanged, but it's all about the outlook. Initial reactions, seeing a little bit of up move. And some weird prints in the VIX. My Amazon butterfly needs a little bit of down movement. I'm going to hold that for now. I could hold it until Friday. The options are Friday expiration, but we'll see what happens here. We get some contraction in that MES, longer duration strangle. I can get out for about 41. It'll hit profit target. It's currently at about 44. The ZB strangle is up about 26%. We get to 30% on that today. I'll take that off as well. I've got a rut duck on that I would normally have taken off because it's kind of. Oh no, I forgot it came back down. Yeah, so it's the May 3rd one. Getting a tiny bit of decay coming in. And a little push up in SPX. Not a lot of movement, but not a lot of decay either. VIX hanging out at 15.54. Iron condors currently up about 3%. I'll close this trade at 25 after the hour, regardless of where it's at. Yeah, that looks right, Kelvin. My rut hedge from yesterday is down a little bit. Where's my other one? Yeah, both of them are down about the same. Was Apple after the bell today? Five two, it's tomorrow after the bell. Yeah, I'll play that tomorrow. Now my Amazon one's down. But yeah, it's down. Those options expire Friday, obviously. So I'll either take it off today or tomorrow, most likely. Just want to see if by chance start, it was coming down today. Wanted to see if FOMC might push it down, but we'll see. As far as Apple goes, I mean, it depends on what happens today, but today and tomorrow. Are you just looking to do the opposite of me, Dick K? I know how your warped mind thinks. Apple's been getting beat down a little bit. Yeah, I don't know. I'm undecided on Apple. Iron condor is up about 8%. Good movement. Good lack of movement. Right back to where we started. I don't Yogadelic. I think from a testing perspective, it does pretty well if it's an up day. So if we do happen to have an up day, I may do a little something discretionary. I'm going to go ahead and put in an order to close my MES strangle at 41 in case I'm not looking at it. I closed the whole thing. My longs started at about 40 cents. Looks like they're down to about 30, 20. All right, got about 10% decay. I get off here in about 10 minutes. Now, if I would have put it on about 5 plus minutes later, so they pumped a little bit in leading up to it. I got in right at about 10 minutes and 10 minutes to until the top of the hour. Oh, my QQQ is at profit target. Did not realize. Go ahead and close that. Be well over 50% of the initial credit.
Their online RN to BSN is nationally accredited, so I know if you graduated from a top-notch nursing program that employers respect. Learn more at wdu.edu. Seems to fit every time.
Yep, up about 15% now. My anecdotal observation of the day after FOMC is that we typically trend in one direction. I think last meeting did not do that, but that is what I tend to remember. So 320, so 321 was the day after. Yeah, that's a pretty small range. Yeah, I remember thinking the day after last time it didn't seem like it normally does on the day after. So here's FOMC day on a 5-minute chart. Last meeting, March 20th. And then here was the day after. Oh, yeah, look at that. That was Premium selling dream right there. High of 60, low of 40. Yeah, this has been perfect. Perfect price movement. My longs on the call side are 20 cents. Put side are 15 cents. I hope so, Ken. All right, I'll be closing this out here in less than a minute. So it looks like I'll book about 20, 21% closing. Filled at 570, in at 715, out at 570. So on a 10 lot, that was good for 1,450, just over 20%. All right, now in 10 minutes, buy some premium, look for a big move. I like that price is still just kind of right near the open on the daily expected move. We still have a lot of room to get to the daily expected move. So if we get anywhere close to the upper or lower, typically we're going to hit our profit target, assuming it does it in a somewhat timely manner. Yeah, I've still got both rut hedges, the one that I put on this morning and the one from yesterday. Both of them are down a tiny bit. Here's the one that I put on today. It's down one, about 200. And the one that expires today that I put on yesterday is down about 300. So those would enjoy some movement as well. And getting some little bounce and some premium coming out now. Did you have the same strikes as me, Chad? 75 80s? Okay. I think we'll probably get filled on this MES strangle unless we get some crazy movement. SPX, a little bounce up to 44. Yeah, we got out right before that little bump. That was nice. All right, about 5 minutes until I enter my next one. Looks like the 70s. 70 puts, 20 puts, 70 calls. Jerome taking the stand, and the market is dropping. Jerome's got his sweet purple tie on today. Purple tie, navy suit. Purple tie is bearish. Yeah. that amazing? Just as soon as he just walks up to the stand, the market reacts. Rusty, can we get the purple tie filter? If I was Jerome, if I knew about that, I would just make weird faces just for fun. All right, a little over a minute. Looks like Jerome kind of forgot to shave his upper lip or something. Like a mustache starter kit going on. All right, SPX back up. I guess it likes the purple tie now. All right. Entering my long strangle. Looks like it should be the 65 calls and the 20 puts. No, 70, 70 20s. 70 20s. Seventy twenties filled at 1670. A 35% profit target. So a quick move down to 5,000 would do it. I'm not even that far. We'll see. Quick move down to 15,15 would do it. 50-15. I like what he did with his bangs today. It's nice. Little little Superman curl going on. Nope, no stop, Mirage. Here come the softball questions. On the upside, we need to move back up to about 75 really quick. VIX down to 15.28. MES trading at about 42.75. SPX approaching the upside expected move to start the day, which was 41.7. Rules, you already hit your 30%. Nice. Mine's at about 13%. Need a quick push up to 80. Another 9 point push would do it. Come on, one more little push. Don't pause. Maybe I'm getting sucked up on the sucked out on this push-up. Yeah, rules. If you got in a little bit lower, strikes for sure, that helped you. So I'm trading at 1960. My profit target's at 2255. VIX collapsing. Say it, we're cutting rates, just and then retract it. Getting close, about a dollar away. A little more. You can do it, buddy. You got this, 50 cents. Oh, it's filled for 35%, 35%. Beautiful. Jerome did his job. Now it can crash. So that was good for 5,855. Thank you, Jerome. I always knew I liked that guy, Jerome. Good guy. It's the purple tie. Good little day. I'm up 12, a little over 12,000 on the day. It's a good FOMC day right there. VXX vertical coming back in. MES is getting close to filling. It's at 41.75. See, I put that calendar on in my Tradier account. Let me set it up here. That was on the 5090 calls. And 4970 puts. Got in at 660. Pushed up above the expected move, pulled right back to it. I feel like FOMC recently, we've seen the initial move kind of stay going that direction, whereas in the past, it sure seemed like the initial move would not be the real one. Let's see what we get today. All right, let's see what some stocks are doing. Starbucks down 17% after earnings. From the high 80s down to the low 70s. CVS down 17% after earnings. SMCI down 11%. AMD down 7.5%, Square down 7.5%. Square has earnings tomorrow. All these stocks that had earnings went down except for the one that I picked, which was Amazon. They'll probably go on for another 45 minutes, another 40 minutes. So one of my rut hedges is down, the one that expires today. The one that expires tomorrow is up. This rut duck is way out of bounds. I'm going to go ahead and close it. SPX still hitting highs of day. Wow, fill it 428 on that rut duck. Well, we've got an up day. SPX up 1.1% from the open. Tranche one would start in 2 minutes. You've got 55 wide. Ooh, it's tempting. It is a trap, Andrew K. You're exactly right. But updates on FOMC day do test okay. Here's tranche one FOMC. Oh. One trade? That's not right. Only one update on FOMC? That just doesn't sound right. I mean, there was an update last meeting. Well, what was this date? March. Okay, it was March 20th. There you go. All right. I thought I remember seeing it did well. Still moving higher. 5087. S&P up 48. Russell up almost 2%. Nope, no runners. So I got out at 22.60. It's currently trading at 23, so not much more. That decay is just sucking it out. Yeah, that was a good exit. That MES should be filling at $41 here soon. Nope, no power hour for me, Kelvin. Yeah, Mirage, what do you want to know? Front option 0 days, back options 2 DTE. It's a double diagonal. So the short puts are 10 points lower than at the money. Short calls are 10 points above the money. And then the longs are 2 days, 2 DTE. And the long puts are 15 points below your shorts. And the longs are 5 points above your, the long calls are 5 points above your short calls. Yep, above or below the current price. That's right. No, above or below your other strikes. So the above and below is based on the short strikes. So the long puts are 15 points below the short puts. SPX up to 50.92. VIX down to 14.41. That's what we call a vol crash, my friends. Jerome doesn't want to answer the question about whether there was any discussion about a rate hike. All right, so we got to a high of 96, back down to 85. Yeah, that's because there's no bid on one of the strikes, Elliot. That'll happen. So look on the option chain. Let's see. On the May 1st. Yeah, there's no bid on the shorts on either the puts or calls. Yeah, if you use the little purple hand and you disable monitoring and then you close it manually, Trade Steward won't have any idea what you did. I missed your message rules. You're welcome. I missed your presence. Yeah, I'm gonna hold on to ZB. And your yield is down almost 1.5%. SPX trying to pop back up. $3, 10, 20, 35. Still 35 wide for tranche two. I might do a little tranche too, Yogadelic. Forty wide. 40 wide filled at 580.
SPX hovering near highs of day. Get some quick decay. Close to 20% already. Percent. Thanks for talking me into it, Yogadelic. At the money butterflies right now, Madam Butterfly are very cheap. I don't even know what they're trading at. Yeah, I don't think today's a day you want to. I don't even know if you get to $2 with 2 minutes to go. News for tomorrow, we've got unemployment claims pre-market. That's about it. Jerome still taking questions. So probably for another 10 minutes. Nice consolidation over the last 30 minutes. Yeah, getting a little rollover. All right, so I just did a little transformer trade. Started out with this unbalanced call condor. Added this, so now I've got two free butterflies, one at the 55 strike and one at the 85-90. SPX back down to the expected move. My 40% profit target is at 340. It's trading at 470. Jerome is done taking questions. Well, I planned to get off earlier, but I'm just having so much fun with you guys that I'm just going to stay on.
385, 40 cents away from hitting my 40%. We hold here or push a little higher, I should hit my 40%. Around tranche three time. Thirty-five, 40 wide for tranche. There's my 40%. My red hedge from yesterday is going to need a push up to 24 or beyond to profit. Which would be several points above high of day. I think if we come back down to the expected move, we break lower.
tested it and bounced a couple times. Still 30 minutes till the bell. Yep, exactly, Marl. So that's at about 50-71. If we go too much lower, I'll get stopped out of my last contract on my little discretionary power hour. Yeah, I just plotted at the beginning of the day. So to start the day, I was 41.7. We are approaching. Let's see if we bounce or if we blow through. Push through a little bit. Stopped on my last remaining contract for profit. There she goes. $65 butterfly might be trading for 50 cents. Maybe. Yeah, right around the bell. So I always look at it right as we're about to open and then. So I try to get it as close to right at the bell as possible. That long duration MES strangle is still trading at about 41.25. Trying to get filled at 41. VIX trying to creep back up to 15. That double calendar that I put on earlier is still basically at break even, maybe a tiny bit red. She's coming down, boys and girls. Well, we got it. We got out of our long strangle just in time. Booked a nice profit on our iron condor. I got my 20 and 40% just in time. Can Amazon follow? Amazon's got two more days. If we can get some downside follow through. Oh, yeah, the double calendar just came alive. The risk graph is not correct, but it's green and getting greener. Oh, yeah, I still have six long puts as well. So half of them for 40 cents. I may have missed it. Yeah, that's tough. Easier said than done, Andrew K, because you never know how far it's going, but yeah, if you can hit it, for sure.
We close red today? Not too far away. NASDAQ just went red. I need Amazon red. It's only 3.5% away. Back down to 41. A little 50-point move in the last 20 minutes. Since when are you a bull, Morrow? Oh, wow, Elliot. I thought you said 20 cents. $20. Beautiful. What were those from, Elliot? Did you just buy those for fun? That's always good. I would take a 55 pin. Okay, can I get a 55 pin? I think we're going to keep going lower. So we got the MOC number in 5 minutes. At the money, 50 butterflies trading for maybe 75, 80 cents. I'm going to try to sell some 55s at $1.20 for my little transformer trade here. That would turn that into a guaranteed profit of 725.
I can get filled. It looks like it's only trading for about 80 cents. Is anyone a big fan of the fruit adventure flavored Tic Tacs? My youngest son got me on these. They're quite delightful. Well, they're Tic Tacs. You know, those little fruit candies? These are fruit adventure is the flavor. He doesn't get the little Tic Tac containers with like 40 in it. He gets these big ones that have like 200 in it. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the Sprite ones. I tried those recently. All right, my MES strangle is touching my $41 order, not filled yet. $1.3 billion sell side. Nothing too big. That double calendar I put on earlier today looks like it's up about 3, 6%, something like that. Going lower. The 34. Russell and Dow are still green, NASDAQ and S&P red. And I guess I'll sell the rest of my puts. $0.75. I mean, you're basically holding short stock. So decay isn't too much of an issue. What are you on, the 60s? Yeah, the 60s, so. So, what'd you buy those for? Oh, nice. 10-bagger. Is it from your long 30 delta strangle? Mine were the 50 20s. Or no, 57, 50 20s on the put side. Yeah, the ruts came back in the valley. Five minutes to go. I guess I'm not going to get a pin on my transformer. Amazon's only up 2%. Got a shot at a profit next couple of days if we get some downside to follow through. Just a little 70-point drop in the last 40 minutes. Looks like a down day tomorrow. Calling my shot, Dick K. Down day tomorrow.
Dick K, are you listening? He's got me on mute. Jerome did us good today, my friends. Jerome did us good today. And the market immediately started dropping as soon as he was done. At the money, 25 butterfly. You might be able to get a dollar. Let's see the 20s. With a minute and a half to go, you might be able to get a dollar 80. You sell your last one, Elliot? Trading at 39. No, you might as well just let it expire. 30 seconds. Little mark down into the close. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ding, ding, ding. 50-18. Looks like they'll settle at about 40-ish something. Nice. All right. So tomorrow is May 2nd, Thursday. So Chad will be streaming live in the morning for Mighty 90 and Runners, and then we'll be back for our regularly scheduled program of Power Hour in the afternoon. All right, everybody, have a good night. Chat with you soon.